Hey, hey, party people, it's Lycona de Chigi, and welcome to the Easy Peasy Guide for Eden's Promise, Litany Savage, better known as E10S. Before we start, click on the like button and subscribe to the channel, because that's what all the YouTube kids are doing these days. It takes less than a GCD to do it, but however you want to help out the channel is cool by me. So, let's get started. We set up our markers like this. They're not too important for the placement, so use whatever your group is comfortable with. You'll also want to assign clock positions, tank, healer, and DPS pairs, and left and right healer groups consisting of a healer and two DPS. One thing to remember about this boss is that his shadow blob underneath him doesn't do any damage to you, so you can move in and out of it at any time. It's just for looks. First up is Deep Shadow Nova, which is just a raid-wide AoE. Next, the boss will cast Implosion, which is a mechanic we'll see throughout the entire fight. He'll place a shadow down on the stage, and think of this shadow as like an arrow, or a directional indicator. The front of the shadow points inward, while the back of the shadow is the thick part with the sort of wall thing coming out of the stage. The key thing to note here is that whenever the boss casts a mechanic, the shadow tells you which direction the cleaves will happen in. Meanwhile, the real cleaves will always appear going through the center of the boss. For this implosion, he'll cast either a forward or a back cleave. To know which cleave he'll be doing, take a look at the real boss. If it's a front cleave, he'll raise his head up and have a green smoke ball in his mouth. If it's a rear cleave, he'll raise his butt up and his tails will start glowing a reddish color. Move to the proper side to dodge these mechanics, and remember, the cleaves appear on the boss, not the shadow. The boss will then stand up, grab a sword, and cast a massive AoE around him, so disengage and dodge towards the outside of the stage. He'll then cast Giga Slash, which will either cleave his shadow's left or right side. For this, pay attention to the sword in his hand. If he's got the sword in his right hand, he'll cleave the right side of his shadow. If he's got the sword in his left hand, he'll cleave the left side of his shadow. He'll then cast Umbra Smash, which is the tank buster. The main tank will take 4 hits and get a magic vulnerability debuff. The off tank should provoke here, and once the 4 slashes are done, the off tank will get one of two mechanics. Shadow's Edge, which is a line AoE tank buster, or Darkness Unleashed, in which the off tank will need to stack with the party, while the main tank who has the magic vulnerability debuff doesn't stack. Next, he'll cast Shadow Cleave. There are a few things that happen during this mechanic, so let's go over each of them one at a time. First, you'll want to get into your clock positions as directional cleaves will come from the boss. Next, a clone of your character will appear behind you and tether to you. These clones will do a little cone AoE if you stand in front of your own, so place your clones away from the middle and then come back in for a stack mechanic. This stack AoE mechanic is a bit special. It will hit the party 3 times, and depending on the number of orbs you see on your clone's head, that will determine which of the 3 AoE stacks you'll not be standing in. If you get 1 orb on your clone's head, you'll skip the first hit and take the second and third hits in the stack. Likewise, if you get 2 orbs on your clone's head, you'll take the first hit, dodge out of the second hit, and then stack for the third. If you get 3 orbs on your clone's head, you guessed it, you take the first and the second hits while moving out of the third. If you get no orbs on your clone's head, congratulations, you win, and you stack for all 3 hits. The boss will then cast Shadow Keeper. You'll put down another clone of yourself that will spawn behind you, so place these clones in the same spot or away from the boss, and then head back into the middle under the boss. Be careful not to get cleaved by your own clone or somebody else's. Next will be an Umbra Smash, which is the tank buster, followed by the line AoE or stack mechanic. And now he'll cast Shadow Servant, which will place 4 little shadows on either the 4 DPS or the tanks and the healers. Next, the boss will rise up and cleave either his left or his right side. Thus, your little shadows that you have on you will also cleave its left or right side. What helps me out here is that I think of my shadow as a little tail on the ground. If I face my character with the shadow behind me, I know that the little shadow is going to cleave either its left or right side. Your little shadow also locks into a cardinal direction, so you'll want to position your character so that the cleave always goes towards the outside of the stage, leaving the middle the safe spot. This mechanic happens twice, once on the DPS and once on the tanks and healers. The order can be different each run, so just be prepared to do it either first or second. The boss will then put his sword away and turn back into a doggo and knock everyone back, so you can use your anti-knockbacks here. Umbra orbs will be cast next, 4 orbs will spawn, 2 big purple orbs, and 2 groups of 3 little orange orbs. Once the cast goes off, these orbs will attack whoever is closest to them. Each tank will take one purple orb on their own, while the healer groups, consisting of a healer and two DPS, will each take their set of the three orange orbs. The orbs' positions spawn sort of randomly, so we set up a priority system. Whichever healer is closest to their orange orbs, they'll stand near it, and the DPS will follow their healers. Then, if the placement gets really weird, we have a left healer group and a right healer group. The left and the right groups actually become more important for another set of Umbra orbs later in the fight, and we found out that having left and right healer groups with a priority system is a little bit more intuitive than remembering a set of rules for every Umbra orb combination. Next, the boss will cast Spawn Shadow. Four doggos spawn on the outside of the stage, one of which will have a shadow tethered attached to them. Follow this doggo around the stage as he'll jump five times. When he stops, you'll want to run towards the side of the stage where he stopped at. He'll then cleave the entire stage with a giant AoE. At the same time, a new set of Umbra orbs come out, so you'll want to line up on the safe edge directly in front of the Umbra orbs you're taking. So the two tanks will each take their own purple orb, and your healer groups will each take their orange orbs. You'll want to be directly in line with the orbs that you're taking. This is a weird mechanic, because technically the orbs attack the closest person to them, but because we're all standing at the edge of the stage, we've had runs where the orbs were further away and would target different people, or the incorrect people, or the correct people, so how we kinda got it to work every single time is that we line up in the same lane as your Umbra orbs. It seemed to work every single time, so we kept doing it this way. Next, the boss will cast Deep Shadow Nova, which is a raid-wide AoE. Then he'll cast Fade to Shadow. The boss will tether to four shadow blobs in the corners of the stage. There are two straight and two squiggly shadow tethers. The shadow blobs with the straight tethers will explode first, while the blobs with the squiggly lines will explode last. The boss will also start to cast Implosion in the middle, so only one corner is the safe spot. How we deal with this mechanic is that we stand under the boss first. We look at which corners have the squiggly lines, and then we see what implosion the boss is doing. Then we move to the safe corner. Once the first set of AoEs go off, we rotate 90 degrees to dodge the next AoE explosions. Deep Shadow Nova happens next, which is a raid-wide AoE, and then he'll cast Implosion. Four shadows will spawn in order, so you'll want to look at the boss and dodge these accordingly. The shadows will appear only once per cardinal direction, but it can be randomized on where each one spawns in succession, so pay attention to where each one spawns next. Another Deep Shadow Nova happens here. He'll stand up again, grab his sword, and cast that massive AoE, so disengage. Next will be Umbra Smash, which is the tank buster, so handle that as you did before. And now we get into Void Gates, or Towers. These first set of towers always spawn on the cardinal spots. You'll want to assign a DPS and a tank or healer to each tower. Giga Slash will come out as the towers are up, and these are the little shadow tails you got earlier where we needed to create a safe box in the middle. So for whoever gets these shadow tails, you'll need to flex and go to a new tower depending on which side the boss cleaves and how your shadow tail is also going to cleave. For the shadow tail people, stand in your new towers, then everyone come back into the middle for another set of towers. For this next set of towers, they will always spawn on the intercardinal spots. So we just have our tower teams rotate clockwise to their new tower. Whoever gets these shadows will need to wait in their tower first, let the tower go off, and then move to your new shadow tail spots. Once you've placed those shadows down correctly, you'll have a safe box in the middle, and let's continue. Next, pitch bogs will come out. These are AoE orbs that appear on everyone's character, so take these out to your clock positions and place them on the outside of the stage. Umbra orbs will come out soon after, and the boss will knock back the party. So use your anti-knockbacks here and get into position to take your orbs. The boss will then cast Implosion twice, so dodge these shadows accordingly. Deep Shadow Nova is next, the raid-wide AoE. And now we get into Shackled Apartus. Tethers will appear on the party, connecting each tank and healer to a DPS. We have the tanks and healers stacked north, while the DPS stacks south. These tethers will explode if you get too close to your tether partner, so just stay at max melee and you'll be fine. The shadow blobs will appear in the corners of the stage, along with the straight and squiggly shadow lines that are connecting to them. First, we simply rotate towards the closest squiggly line. Then, we pay attention to the Umbra orbs that spawn here. Their configuration dictates how we move as a party to satisfy those orbs. So, let's go over each configuration. If we have the orange orbs on opposite sides, while looking at the boss from our tethered spots, we call out normal movements. The healers and the DPS can move to their right or left side groups respectively, then then take their orb stack. Same with the tanks and their purple orbs. If the orbs are on the same side, the tanks will rotate towards their purple orbs and then they'll take their left and right orb respectively. The healer and the DPS groups will both rotate towards the orange orb side, then take their orbs in their left or right groups. So the movement is tanks and healers north, DPS south, rotate towards the closest squiggly line, watch for the Umbra orbs, determine how you'll move after the AoEs go off, rotate to your new spot, dodge the AoE first, then split left and right to take your orb. Deep Shadow Nova will come out again, so that's the raid-wide AoE. He'll stand up and cast that giant AoE around him, but at this point, you'll want to get into your clock positions because Pitch Bogs come out right after. Place your Pitch Bogs down on the outside of the stage, and then the boss will cast Giga Slash. There will be four slashes, so take a look at the boss and see which side of his shadow he's going to slash, then dodge accordingly. After you dodge the shadow slashes four times, go back and stand in your Pitch Bog AoE. You'll get sucked into the middle and a clone of your character will appear. The boss then casts Void Gate Amplifier and eight towers are placed on the stage. Four towers in the middle and four towers in the corners. The weird thing here is that each tower needs two people in it, which means that you need a total of 16 people to satisfy these towers. Luckily, every person has a clone, so we'll need to place our clones in these towers as well as ourselves. We have our tanks and melees take the inside towers, and our healers in range take the outside towers. The boss will then cast Shadow Keeper, which at the end of the cast, your clone will be placed behind your character. So place this clone in your tower. Just be careful here, because if you're facing a different way, your clone won't be placed in the tower, and you won't have enough people to satisfy the towers. You'll only be able to place your clones once, so gotta get it right. After you've placed your clone, you'll need to run to another tower. For us, we just ran clockwise. The reason for this is you can't be next to your own clone because if they sneeze on you, you'll get hit with their little AoE and you'll die. Also, be careful here as you don't want to stand in front of another person's clone because they might sneeze on you and you'll die. Now that everyone has a clone in their tower and are standing in their tower, let the tower mechanics resolve. Once that happens, four new towers will spawn at the same time. Everyone will get an AoE on them. Place these AoEs away from the other clones, because if your clone gets hit with one of these AoEs and dies, you also die. Tanks and healers will want to get the new set of towers, the clones will disappear, and the DPS will get a green tether attaching them to either a tank or a healer partner. The DPS should follow these green tethers into their partner towers, everything resolves, and you're good to go. Umbra Smash comes out next, so tank, do your tank things. Umbra Orbs will spawn in the corners one last time, along with a knockback. So look at your orbs, get into your groups, hit your anti-knockbacks, and take your orb hits in your healer DPS groups or as a tank. He'll then cast two Deep Shadow Novas and then his Enrage. And then if you had enough DPS during the fight, congratulations on your clear. As always, I'd like to thank my raid team and all of you out there. Every so often I'll get a message in game saying how these guides have helped you and your team get your clears, and I'm so happy to hear about it. Whatever we can do to help out the raiding community is cool by me. So until next time, get those clears, challenge those raids, and keep on adventuring.